Hi everybody, my name is Connie Marigo and we're broadcasting here from a beach along Nantucket Sound in the outer Cape Cod. And we have just released 3 sea turtles back into the ocean. These turtles stranded back in December as part of a group that came in very hypothermic, which we call cold stunning in sea turtles. And that's when the turtles get too cold because the water temperature is dropping and they're just not able to sustain themselves. They stranded here on the Cape in December. They came to the New England Aquarium for rehabilitation. They were just recently declared releasable by our staff veterinarians. We brought them down here today for a big release. 2 of the sea turtles that we released this morning were satellite tagged. So this is a process where we actually glue the tag onto the shell. So the top shell is hard, and the satellite tag is glued onto a piece of fiberglass and it sits on some putty, and that whole system is glued right onto the shell. We have a permit that allows us to put the satellite tags on. There are stipulations in that permit and regulations in that permit, and one of those is that the tag size does not create too much drag for these turtles when they go back into the ocean. So it's a very small tag. The regulations are under 10%, but we generally keep it under 2% body weight. So it's, again, you're calculating how much drag does that little tag cost on the turtle as it's swimming through the ocean. So we look at the size of the turtle and the size of the tag. We run all the calculations and we make sure we're well under the allowed percentage of drag for the turtles. It's pretty harmless and it actually is designed to fall off as the scutes peel up, which is a natural process, and that top shell is made of these little scutes. And that's almost like a carrot, and that will peel off eventually. And when those peel off naturally, the tag will fall off. And then we can follow or track the turtles. So we're looking at survivorship post-release and post-rehab. And we're also looking where do these turtles go? We want to understand what habitat are they using out here. And that helps us protect those habitats. So we will be tracking those turtles over the next weeks and months, and hopefully up to a year. And then the third turtle that we released was an endangered Kemp's Ridley sea turtle. After months of rehab, today was a really great and welcome day to see them crawl back into the ocean and hopefully resume normal behavior and get back to their lives. Thanks everybody for joining us today for this virtual sea turtle release here on Cape Cod, and we hope to see you at the New England Aquarium soon.